Oh man, it's real early in the morning. Oh God. Alright, so today I'll be looking over, talking about some new updates about my channel, and also I'll be showing you my collection of tanks and things that I made. Anyways, basically this is just to show a rundown of all the things I created right now at the start of this part of the channel, because I updated it. So this will just show my current collection, and it also to clear up some stuff. But right here is my shelf of collection, and is my shelf of creations I made. And if you didn't know, I make a lot of tanks and stuff out of cardboard. For these stop motions, I make my own props because I don't buy my own. Like most stop motion makers, I just have toy soldiers and a lot of tanks. And the good thing about making your own tanks is that you can make any tank you want. So once you have the skill to make the tanks, it's pretty good skill. So I'm just gonna show a rundown of this whole collection. And I'm recording really early in the day right now because when it's early, there's better light, I guess. Yeah. Let me talk about why I started making tanks and these things. So, the first instance where I made a tank is this tiny miniature tank. This is a toy soldier comparison. And my voice. Oh man. It's either puberty, it's really early in the morning. Anyways, this is a toy soldier compared to this tank. This is just a little mini Sherman that I made. All of these creations I made at first were just compared to this World War II book I had. I don't even know where it is now. Yeah, right here on my bookshelf. I keep things organized. So this is the World War II book I had. It's a sticker book. I got it from a bookstore during school. And it shows a bunch of tanks and stuff. So this is where I started making my things. At school, I used to have a lot of time because I would finish my assignments and then I would just sit there. But then I decided to create these things. And I made a lot more of these, but that's the end of that. And if you want to know how to make this mini tank, you could comment in the description below. I'll probably make a tutorial anyways. This is a pretty cool little tank you could have at your desk as a decoration. Anyways, on to the next one. This is a pretty ugly tank. Now, I made this during last summer with my cousins because I had to live with my cousins for 2 months. And we decided to make an army man stop motion in their garden. Now, we did make the stop motion, but it turns out 2 months wasn't enough time to finish the stop motion. And then, I couldn't go back to the house that often to finish it. And then, I also stored all my files into their computer and they got deleted. God damn it. So let's just say I failed making a stop motion. But I did make this tank for the stop motion. Now, this tank is pretty hideous. It's made out of paper, and I made it for the stop motion. Yeah, it's kind of ugly, and this is basically the first instance where I made props for a tank. So this is the first try. I mean, it's pretty good. It's better than most things. All right, now there are these tanks. Now this is a tank I made in September on my brother's birthday, and this is supposed to be a Sherman. It doesn't look like that, so yeah, it was supposed to be a Sherman. This is the first tank I made. It's not that good. It's kind of weird shaped because it's like really steep. I don't know. This is the first one I made, and it's not that good, but it's better than most things you might see. Then there's, alright, this was supposed to be the American M26 Persian Heavy Tech. I made everything according to this book. That was supposed to be this, so there's an American symbol on the back. I made this out of my friend's sanitizer bottle. He just gave it to me. He was like, hey, what can you make out of this? I guess I can make a tank out of it. This is basically the second tank I've ever made, so pretty good. Then there's a T-34 now. This is basically the breakthrough. As you can see, I started making better mechanisms. Look, you can smoothly move this up and down. And a lot of, some people were requesting, like, they were excited about how to make the T-34. Now, this is the T-34. You can tell that's a bottle cap up there. I don't know if this looks that much like a T-34. Let me see. I mean, it doesn't look perfectly close, but it has the same markings and stuff. These are actually all Allied tanks from World War II. So now we're gonna move on to the... So these are all the German tanks I have right now. So these... Alright, so this is the... this is the Panzer, I'm pretty sure. So this is the Panzer, this is the Panther, and this is the Tiger. Those are the most famous German tanks. So the Panzer is like the smallest one, Panther, medium, and then Tiger is like the biggest. And these are all the other ones. This one's pretty good, you know, looks pretty good, and it's really breaking a little bit. Oh, I should really glue that back into place. This one has the up and down movement again. Really big. This one's really big. So this is a Tiger. It's extremely big, and I don't think it looks that much like the original, but still looks pretty cool. So these are all the Germans. All right, on to the artillery guns. So this is the first artillery gun I made. And I wanted them all to have a recoil mechanism, so you can just like animate it like that. That's how these artillery guns work. They also have moving wheels. As you can see, the wheel moves. All of them have moving wheels. Yeah, they're pretty cool. This one my dog chewed up, but I managed to fix it. That's why it's a little white. This is probably the best. This was a howitzer I made for my D-Day video, and it's pretty good. I mean, look at it, it's really high detailed, someone was requesting how to make one of these, and this howitzer, these I already made before, and I didn't make tutorial videos, but this one, I made a tutorial video on it. It's not up on YouTube yet, because I was waiting for my channel to refresh, you know, the revamp, or whatever, I don't even know, the change, so then I would upload it. So I actually filmed how to make this already, this howitzer. On my channel, I already filmed it, but I didn't post it yet, so I'll post it, I don't know, around after this video is posted. I have a lot of videos ready to be uploaded. So this is a howitzer, it rolls, this is supposed to be towed and stuff. Oh my god, are you kidding me? I wonder if my neighbors can hear me right now, maybe I should be a little more quiet. Alright, on to the other vehicle. So now here, there's two landing crafts for D-Day. And this one, I kind of hot glued some soldiers onto it. And when I pulled them off, it took the paint with them. So that was bad, but these landing crafts are pretty good. You can close the doors. They're pretty high detailed on the sides. There's like rust and all that stuff, you know. So some person was asking about this, how to make these. I might make a tutorial, but I don't think I'll make the same exact ones. But I think, I don't know, it's really hard. Here's the battleship for also D-Day. It's not actually up to scale. So this boat is also high detailed, pretty good. It's actually hollow in the inside because I was lazy. Now this is these truck thingies. I don't know what they're called, but you put stuff in here and it has like the sheet stuff. I don't know what they're called at all. And also I gave it ability to tow things. So if I pull one of these over, it can actually tow this. Everything is compatible. You can actually tow this thing around, which is pretty interesting. Although it doesn't work that well. Yeah, this thing has moving wheels too. I made part of this during school. There's a toy soldier man inside. I did not realize that. Maybe I should take this guy out. Now on to the bunker. This was just a bunker for D-Day. And there's nothing really special about it. It's just a bunker. Now this is an interesting. It's a tank, but it doesn't shoot. It just it has ramps. So this was in World War II. It was used to like help carry tanks around. In my D-Day video, I explained the use of these, and also I provided an animation. Alright, now I think I should close my window actually. That's a lot better. Alright, now on to this Star Wars stuff. So I only brought two over here because the other ones are pretty big. This is this bunker that I made. Someone was asking about how to make this too. I don't know why would you want to make this. It's just an indoor bunker for Star Wars. The doors can open and close. This was a prop made for it. It's pretty easy to make. As you can see, the back is just cardboard. Opens up. I had some vines and some green stuff. This is what I'm pretty proud of. So this is an AT-ST. Let me just say, it's pretty hard to make. It doesn't balance on its own. So when I was animating this for Star Wars versus Army Men, I had to use a stand. You should really check out the behind the scenes for Star Wars versus Army Men or any of my stop motions. Yeah, this thing could stand by itself, but it's pretty hard to animate. So this thing, pretty proud of, because it has movable legs. And as you can see, I made it out of a straw. You can see a tad bit of that right there. This is also straw. The guns, you know, everything. Oh, here is what I used to attach to the stand. So in my opinion, this is a pretty cool build, but nothing in compared to the AT-AT. As you can see, that's an AT-ST right there. That thing is huge compared to this tank. I just realized I forgot to review this tank. Alright, right now, this is a Hago tank. It's a Japanese tank. It's really unique because, you know, it has that weird shape that you don't think of with tanks. I made this at my cousin's house. That's all you really need to know. Pretty cool. The AT-AT has movable limbs. If you haven't seen my animation on it, I'm pretty sure you all have, but pretty cool. The head can move side to side. This is a TIE fighter. I made a tutorial on how to make this. And yeah, it's just a normal TIE fighter. It doesn't look that cool, but I still have it. These were all made for the Star Wars versus Army Men. That's a model I showed you guys how to make before. What I want to show you is these planes right here. Alright, so these planes, in my video, someone was like, has anyone noticed the gay plane? Yeah, I put that in there. Gay. So these are the planes I made. They have turnable turrets. Turbines. Yeah, that's what I meant. I hung most of them up here. There's like two of them. I made three of them. I took this one down for animation. But that is the British Spitfire. This is some other bombers and stuff. You can see I strung them up there. They look pretty cool as decorations, but those are the planes basically. Now I wanted to talk about these three. So I didn't talk about two of these yet. But right here, these are the new vehicles and stuff I made for tutorials, but I haven't released them yet. So I made tutorials on how to make these, but I didn't post the video on it yet. So these are new vehicles. I will show tutorials on how to make all of these. There's this Jeep with a machine gun, artillery gun, and this is the World of Army Toys or something. I don't have good memory. She requested how to make a T-30 something, I don't know. She said T-34 and T-30 something. So this is it, and I will post a tutorial on how to do that soon. That's basically a lot of stuff. That's my I almost forgot. This is a new vehicle that I made. There's a tutorial on it already, and I forgot to show it. This is just a one tank. You can watch the tutorial on how to make this cool thing on my channel. So I will be posting a lot more how-to videos in the future, and hopefully you like them, because these things are pretty cool. So anyways, thank you all for watching this tour. I will post more videos, as I said, and more stop motions, as you can see. And yeah, that's what I'll be doing, and hopefully you stay tuned. Also, I just wanted to mention, you should follow me on Instagram, because why not? On Instagram, Instagram at Nim Productions, so you know, it's just Nim Productions. You can go on my Instagram. I will post like pictures of the tanks and stuff early on my Instagram, and also I'll post a bunch of random stuff. So if you want to see future things that I'll make, you can follow me on Instagram, and then I'll post early pictures before I post the tutorial. That's how it'll go, and that's what I'll be doing. So make sure to follow me on Instagram. Thank you all for watching, and yeah, I need to go back to sleep now.